So can you have a fair witch hunt? John Berman here in for Anderson. The question comes up because President Trump has been talking, but there are new questions about what he is saying. He spoke at length with the New York Times off the cuff with no aides present, and he made news on the Russia investigation, a new response on whether he thinks it's fair, a witch hunt, or both. Here's what he said when the Times asked him about Robert Mueller. He said this, "I hope that he's going to be fair," he said. "I think he's going to be fair, and based on that, there's been no collusion, but I think he's going to be fair. And if he's fair, because everybody knows the answer already." So there's a great deal open to interpretation here, but the fair part is new. And one thing is abundantly clear, this is not how he normally talks about the investigation. This is.
This Russia thing with Trump and Russia is a made-up story.
The entire thing has been a witch hunt.
There's been no collusion, no obstruction, and virtually everybody agrees to that.
The president went on to say, "I think that Bob Mueller will be fair, and everybody knows there was no collusion. I saw Dianne Feinstein the other day on television saying there is no collusion. She's the head of the committee." Now, keeping them honest, Senator Feinstein has yet to publicly reveal that she has reached any determination one way or another on collusion or collaboration, and it's hard to know exactly which of her remarks the president is referring to. Here's what she told Wolf Blitzer back in May.
"Do you have evidence that there was in fact collusion between Trump associates and Russia during the campaign?"
"Not at this time."
Again, that was in May, before the indictment of Paul Manafort, the president's former campaign chair. It was before campaign advisor George Papadopoulos pleaded guilty to lying about campaign contacts with Russia, before president's former national security advisor Michael Flynn also pleaded guilty. It was before we learned about that meeting at Trump Tower last year, Manafort, Jared Kushner, and Donald Trump Jr. sitting down with Russians promising Kremlin-provided dirt on Hillary Clinton. A lot has happened since May. So perhaps the president was talking about this interview, Senator Feinstein, back in early November with Jake Tapper.
"So we learned this week that former Trump foreign policy advisor George Papadopoulos traveled to London in March 2016. And then in April, he met with a professor who promised dirt on Hillary Clinton from the Russians. Have you seen any evidence that this dirt, these emails, were ever given to the Trump campaign?"
"Not so far."
"Not so far. Have you seen any communications that suggested that the Trump campaign wanted them to release them through a different means? Because obviously they were ultimately released by WikiLeaks."
"No, I have not."
Senator Feinstein neither implicating nor clearing the president, only saying she had yet to see evidence the Trump campaign tried to get the WikiLeaks emails. And what Senator Feinstein has said more recently is hardly comforting to the president.
"The Judiciary Committee has an investigation going as well. And it involves obstruction of justice. And I think what we're beginning to see is the putting together of a case of obstruction of justice."
A case of obstruction of justice. You did not hear the president quoting that. But back to what he did say, his claim that everybody agrees, even Democrats, that there was no collusion. Well, here is Mark Warner, the Democratic co-chair of the Senate Intelligence Committee, just last week speaking in defense of Robert Mueller.
"Despite the initial denials of any Russian contacts during the election, this committee's efforts have helped uncover numerous and troubling high-level engagements between the Trump campaign and Russian affiliates, many of which have only been revealed in recent months."
Doesn't sound like he's clearing the president. And then there is what the president said on the possibility of reopening the Clinton email probe. Quote, "I have absolute right to do what I want to do with the Justice Department, but for purposes of hopefully thinking I'm going to be treated fairly, I've stayed uninvolved with this particular matter." So is he saying the decision not to impede or influence these investigations is somehow conditional? It depends on whether he thinks he is being treated fairly? Is that what he's saying? To be honest, we don't know for sure. The question is, does he?